For this riveting video, I'm going to show you how I installed these Festool Cross Members on my MFT3. Exciting stuff, I know. So inside the $86 box, we have the two Festool Cross Members, a bracket for the left side of your table, and a bracket for the right side of your table, and of course, the all-important instructions. You will need a 6mm hex key to secure the brackets to the rail profile, and a 10mm wrench to make life easier when you tighten the premium plastic clip at the end of the cross members. Let's get started with this install, shall we? So if you're looking for some additional lateral stability on your MFT3 or your 1080 and have about $200 burning a hole in your pocket, then I'd say give these a whirl. And yes, I can still attach my fence with the cross members installed, which is a plus. Now some of you may recall a scene from a previous video I did showing you how unstable my setup was without the use of these stabilizers. Now I really don't see myself doing a whole lot of hand planing on this bench, so if I were to remove these, the excessive lateral movement really wouldn't bother me. Now the price tag Festool puts on this accessory is quite outlandish if you ask me, especially when you consider what it is and what it does. And this quote accessory should really be included with the MFT3 or 1080 in the first place. You shouldn't have to shell out another $180 on a $600 or $700 multifunction table setup to make it less like an unbalanced washing machine. And on that note, I'm going to call this done. I hope you found this video useful and mildly entertaining. If you haven't already, I'd like to invite you to subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have any questions or comments about this video, please feel free to leave those below and I will address them when I can. As always, thanks for watching, and until next time, take care and have a good one.